chilling tales for dark nights.
A Sketchy Interview, written by Matt Dymerski, narrated by Jeff Clement.
I had a job interview yesterday that rather bothered me. The ad was rather vague, but I was as desperate for a job as the next guy, so I jumped on the interview offer. I did think it was odd that the interview was so late. By the time I found the place, inky autumn darkness surrounded the building like a sinister halo, held back only weakly by buzzing orange street lamps. Set at the back of a wide parking lot wasteland, the place seemed like it fit perfectly with the rest of the factory district. A long, low, and massive structure, sided with aluminum and brick. Maybe it was just the dim lamplight, or the curious silence beyond the electric buzzing overhead. But I immediately disliked the place. The chilly walk up had me constantly looking around, as if someone might rush from the distant darkness and rob me. Yeah, if they wanted to run a half mile across dim orange parking lot. For a few tense minutes, I tried blank doors set in the side of the building. There was no indication which one was the actual entrance. They were all locked. And I was just starting to think someone was playing a prank on me, when one finally swung open. The interior was almost hilariously normal. A nice, clean office waiting room lay within. My concerns about my situation faded, and I smiled with relief.
I'm here for the, I began to say, approaching the receptionist window.
There was nobody on duty. The space behind the window was dark and empty. Confused, I examined the waiting room. The lights were on, and the front door was open. Surely somebody was working. Maybe they just didn't have a receptionist this late. So, what? Was I supposed to just walk into the rest of the building? Find my potential boss by wandering around? I silently cursed the vague interview directions. The sound of glass clinking glass faintly radiated from somewhere. Peering through the receptionist window, I called out, but the shadowed office beyond remained silent. I tried a door at the back of the waiting room, locked. I tried the one next to it, and it swung open easily, surprisingly. Embarrassed, I stepped through, hoping nobody saw me stumble with the door. The other side opened up into a vast, cavern-like space filled with machinery. The jumbled mechanical beasts lay quiet and dim. Was this a manufacturing job? On the far side of the factory, I saw a single bright light hanging over an active machine. I approached the operator carefully. Overweight and hunched uncomfortably over the controls, he seemed to be quite focused. As I grew closer, I shouted over the rising mechanical screech.
Hello?
He ignored me, or didn't hear me.
Hi. I'm here for the interview,
I shouted, circling the machine so he could see me. The screeching stopped abruptly, and the machine died with a fading whir. He looked up and lifted his goggles onto his forehead, resting them on his greasy, matted hair. His beady eyes, set above glistening, sallow cheeks, focused on me for a long moment.
Good, good, he finally grumbled. This'll be a field interview. Get it?
I did my best not to look wary.
This machine needs some nimble hands.
I don't follow. Huffing, he leaned over, opened a hatch in the machine, and pointed back through a mess of gears, pistons, and other components I didn't recognize or understand.
See that? A wrench fell back in there. I can't reach it.
Leaning close to him to see inside, I held my breath against his rank body odor. The air near him seemed to be moist with sweat, and his breath was a foul mix of smoke and... liquor? Not wanting to be rude, I said nothing.
You want me to reach in and get it out?
I asked, wondering if he was serious.
Well, I sure can't do it.
He shot back, rubbing his round belly near strange stains on his shirt. I considered the idea. The machine was rather low and wide. To reach the back, I'd have to crawl completely inside the hatch, among all sorts of components that were obviously in motion when the machine was in operation.
Shouldn't you power it off or something?
It is off, kid.
But I just saw you running it.
Just in maintenance mode. Now get in there, or don't you want this job?
Frowning, I leaned closer to the hatch. In the corner of my eye, I saw him lick his lips. I was thoroughly freaked out. But I needed a job. I leaned in a little, trying not to get too near any of the jagged parts that might suddenly start moving. Shaking, I reached out, but I couldn't reach anywhere near the back.
Come on, get all the way in there.
I imagined I could barely detect a strange note of excitement in his tone. I moved in another few inches. In the muffled, cramped darkness within, I peered around at the pistons and tubes near my head. I had the sudden fear that, once I crawled inside, he would shut the hatch behind me, trapping me, and I still couldn't see the wrench he was talking about. I could almost feel the pistons coming down and crushing me, or the gears rotating and ripping into my limbs. No job was worth this. I slid out.
Sorry, man, I gotta go.
Making some polite excuses, I practically bolted back out through the waiting room and into the chilly night, immensely relieved. I spent the drive back running over the events in my head, wondering if I'd just read too much into everything, wondering if I'd freaked myself out for no reason and blown a chance at a real job. As my fear faded, I began shaking my head at my own stupidity. It had been nothing, and I'd probably really offended the guy. When I got home, I had an email about the interview. My blood ran cold as I read the apology. The man I was supposed to meet had sent me the wrong address.